Did you know that music can cause deep and lasting changes in the brain? It's true. That's why we should increase the number of music lessons in schools. Remember the Mozart effect? It claimed that listening to Mozart's music could boost mental functions. While that might not be entirely true, recent neuroscience research shows that practicing music, rather than just listening to it, has some fantastic benefits. So, what happens to a child's brain when they practice music for an hour a day? Research has shown that playing an instrument from childhood improves sound processing in the brain, helping with learning. This means that musicians can focus better in noisy environments and multitask more effectively. Pretty cool, right? But wait, there's more. Playing an instrument can even help with learning new languages. Just imagine how useful that could be in today's globalized world. Unfortunately, not all schools provide the opportunity to learn instruments, and music lessons are often the first to be cut due to budget constraints. Researchers Nina Kraus and Bharath Chandrasekaran have highlighted this disturbing trend of limiting music lessons in curricula. Between 1999 and 2004, the number of students participating in music activities in California public schools dropped by a whopping 50%. So, what's the solution? We need to maintain and improve musical education in schools. While the primary motivation for playing an instrument should always be the pure joy of it, we can't ignore the positive impact music has on brain development. Let's make sure our school curricula reflect this, even with limited funds. After all, music isn't just a whim. It's a powerful tool for learning and growth.